forest and people codependent? Can one exist without the other?
Early in Dr. Marla McIntosh's urban forestry class, students recognize that urban areas survive with people, but people cannot exist without green.
Everything in urban forestry depends on another. Like, we depend on the environment depends on us.
Why do we need urban forests and green infrastructure?
Why do we care? As University of Maryland students, we are learning from experts, from lectures, and from field experience. Educate the community. Right tree, right place, diversity.
The class had another hands-on experience with urban forestry during a trip to a botanical garden and zoo, Dr. McIntosh's backyard.
Dr. McIntosh presented important aspects of the ecosystem with actual examples in her backyard. Not your typical yard.
This course is not about the tree or even landscapes. But it's about landscapes and
students learn to look at landscape architecture as part of the environment that affects the entire community.
Our environment is the most important thing to us.
After exploring the natural habitats of mosquitoes, butterflies, and even poison dart frogs, students were already developing a new appreciation for a sustainable environment. Mike Ropp led a guided tour on campus, taking a practical and hands-on approach to education. Diversity and evolution are key themes that are incorporated into every class discussion.
It is one thing to discuss urban forestry in a lecture, but another to apply it to real-life situations.
Has it rained in a week? This soil should be pretty darn dry.
The experience with Bartlett Tree Care Expert brought urban forestry concepts to life.
Jonathan Kays handled the topic of forest ecology during a lecture. He explained the three essential needs of trees and plants: light, water, and nutrients.
They get their nutrients, their epiphytes they're called. They get their nutrients from the air.
Management of the forest is the appropriate way to preserve it, because forests are normally healthier if they're maintained rather than left alone.
75% of the people that own forests in the state of Maryland own under 10 acres. So we're actually developing educational programs for backyard forestry.
In fact, land is shaped by human activity. We've all seen numerous specimens of urban wildlife, even if we're not aware of it. Urban wildlife is everywhere around us. People normally appreciate nature in cities.
I also like it because the tree here provides shade for my laptop, so I can see the screen if I have my computer out.
Our urban wildlife needs green space as much as we do. Ken Allman, a Howard County councilman, spoke to the class about balancing growth and urban sprawl and showed how government's decisions can affect the environment.
So it's been really cool to hear from people who are working with just neighborhoods and citizens with their personal trees, and then others that are working at the legislative level.
And the way zoning is traditionally done.
Former Maryland Department of Natural Resources Secretary Sarah Taylor Rogers also emphasized the importance of collaboration between government and communities, saying, "Often, a simple phone call from a citizen can make a big difference in what is addressed in the communities. Sometimes the political will needs a kick in the pants from the individual will."
I believe that it's all the people's responsibility to take care of their environment.
Students learn the relevance of urban forestry.
But after this class, I know the importance of having the right tree.
plant in the right place.
The importance for us to go and actively seek out information that we might not already know about that might not be as widely publicized.
After this course, I've kind of realized, you know, how important trees are, how they affect us.
It's changed my perception a lot, just noticing everything on campus a lot more.
This added on knowledge has just brought a whole new dimension to the way I perceive and see things.
Actually, it is true. They said the first day you'll never look at a tree the same. And, well, God, I'm embarrassed, but I actually look at trees differently now.
Every student now has the tools to incorporate urban forestry concepts, values, and ethics in their own lives.
I know that I got a lot more than I bargained for when I signed up for the class. But I think a lot of the students that are in this class that are not science majors and were only taking the class to get a core science lab requirement, I think that they're getting a whole lot more out of this class than they ever dreamed that they would. And it's just been a great learning experience for everyone.